Welcome to the 138th Step Up Canned Workouts pre-recorded exercise. And we'll get to the main screen now. How are you? This is the second recorded. No, I'm fine. This is the second recorded one. Well, not recorded, but I've done the live one, and this is the recorded one for next week or today, whichever you're watching this. So, exercise of step up. So, we're going to need a step. Dumbbells, water, and that's about it. And, oh, my notes. I'll do my notes. Right, get them correctly there. So we're gonna do two sets of steps, one at the beginning, one at the end, one intermediate exercise set, basically doing cardio and a little bit of core. Right, so, may as well get it over and done with, actually. So let's start with the warm-up. Why does that look odd? There we go, that's better. Right, warm-up. So, nice. Up, up, down, down. Nice and easy. Since we're doing two sets of step, I will be doing a static stretch in a moment. Remember, if you do static stretch before exercise, don't do it for any more than 10 seconds, otherwise you will stretch the muscle too much for stability for the joints. So what I'm doing is I'm just warming up the muscle a little bit to then be able to stretch it more efficiently. There we go. In beat. Me as the clock running really slowly. Three seconds, change your feet, and change. So get those arms moving as well at the same time, get them working. Remember to move your wrists at the same time as well, so you're actually working the forearms. We're going round if you want, with your fingers. Pump those elbows. Seconds, we'll do thigh stretch. Three, two, one. So 10 second thigh stretch, so quick up. Just squeeze, you don't have to look up or anything like that. Just pull it up, squeeze it. Three, two, one, change sides. That. Two, one, reverse lunges. Really try and push that heel backwards as well. So you're stretching your calf. So you don't have to get your knee down. You're just stretching that calf. So try and get that heel back. Three, two, one. Brilliant, right, might in the spot. Let's get those arms working. Up and out. Fan those arms out. Ready? Soon. Nice wide stance. Let's do some punching. Oh, this sounds like getting in. You don't have to clap. Keep to me tight through this. We're out with the punch down. Get those elbows up nice and high. Rock slightly from side to side if you want, but remember to keep your hips back. You ready? So much on the spot. Shake yourself off. Let's get ready for the main workout. Move that forward a little bit.
3, 2, 1.
Let's go.
Exercise 1.
It's actually slower than the workout, than the warm-ups, isn't it? As it's all put down now, remember. We'll swap legs in the second, or after the active rest. Active rest, you could do flick kicks or march on the spot, whatever you want to do. Just keep moving.
3, 2, 1,
active rest. So I'm going to do flick kicks, or you can do march on the spot. Whichever one you want to do. Keep that heart rate up. And just swap legs. I start in the green, so I'm going to go in the pink.
3, 2, 1.
Pink.
Exercise 2.
Position now, or it might be better than normal. I don't know. Right. Twin seconds. Excellent. Keep on going.
3, 2, 1.
Excellent, so we're going to do side transitions. We're going to stand by the side of the board. We're going to step, on step, and twist. So you, as you step, you're stepping and twisting and coming off. Got to be careful, especially on smaller steps, that you're actually not going to be doing any injury or sliding off.
Exercise 3.
Try and get those hips to rotate. Don't do the rotation through the knees. Seconds.
3, 2, 1. Change.
Right, active rest again. Right, this time what we're going to do, we're going to start on the board and we're going to do reverse lunges off. So I'm going to move this a little bit further forward so I've got more room backwards. We're not going down that far. Just until you actually nicely feel it in your thigh.
2, 1.
You ready?
Exercise 4.
So reverse lunge back. A bit of a deficit. You don't want to do reverse lunges, then just do up, up, down, down, and change in 3 seconds. So if you're doing up, up, down, down, change now. Side. So this one, you step on, arms up, leg out, arms up, leg out. Try and point that toe downwards, try not to point it out to the side, otherwise your hip, your glutes taking over.
Exercise.
Let's go. Try and get a 45 degree angle with your entire body, so it's diagonal. Let's have a look. I tend to keep my back leg, doesn't matter. It's all about just moving the arms and leg at the same time to increase that heart rate.
Three, two, one.
Active rest again.
Exercise.
We're going to do basic up, up, down, down. But with the arms out, when you're down on the floor, when you go forward, your hands sweep up, up in front of you. At the same time as doing up, up, down, down. On one leg, well,
You start on one leg.
Three, two.
So arms out.
One. Exercise six.
Step up and out. To get more, if you want to rest a little bit, bring your arms round in a nice arc. So you're not just really working the shoulders, because a lot of people tend to just go straight out like that. That'll really work the shoulders a lot. So a nice sweep round will actually work more of the shoulder muscles. So you're not weakening just one. And the music stopped again. So on the active rest,
three,
we'll do it,
two,
we'll change it.
One.
So shake your arms
change
off,
exercise.
Active rest. Let's go. So we're swapping legs, still doing the arm motions.
Three, two, one. Exercise seven.
Hooked. I'm doing knee ups with arm actions then. You can see I tend to like play my hand out, so actually so the palms are facing backwards as I go back, as I go up. My arms actually go behind my body. Right, okay, active rest. What we're going to do this time, we're going to go step, step, punch, punch, step, step, change foot, step, step, punch, punch, step, step, change foot. Now remember which one you do. Okay?
Three,
you can do it to the corners if you want.
One. Exercise eight.
If you've got one board, let's go. Twist to the side and do it. So as you twist the step up, then punch to the side, come down.
Three.
Oops, what's that tray?
One. Change exercise.
I hope he's got enough power. Right. If he's not got enough power, we'll have to make it up. Let's just finish off
exercise
up, up, down, down. If it goes off, it goes off. What we'll do is we'll just have to play it by ear. I'll have to try and count in my head maybe, so I might go a bit quiet. Rest. Then we're going to change legs for the last exercise. You notice, when I do this, this is actually a low, class as a low impact exercise.
Three, two,
because one foot's
exercise
always on the ground.
Two.
Right, opposite leg. Be ready for my lunch after this, even though it's morning for you. Levinses. Right. 20 seconds left. 15. I thought I charged that up earlier on. Anyway, it's getting old.
Three.
Two. One. Brilliant. Right, water break time. So I'm going to move the mat forward slightly. I am going to turn the box so it's ready for the second exercise. Because we're just going to do squats for the first one. If we do run out of power on that, we'll do repetitions. And we'll have to play it back here. Probably 20 reps for each one. Just so you can get the cardio going. Some of you think 20 reps. Well, whilst we're waiting, we're still processing. That's it. Video I'm just processing onto YouTube now. Right, so the first exercise we're going to do a squat. So basically, shoulder width apart, knee slightly bent. You're going to put your hips back. Try and look forward at all times. Hands out to counterbalance you. If your knees go in, try and keep them out. If your knees go out, try and keep them in. So follow them on your feet. Whichever way your feet face, your knees have to follow. Let's go. Try and get a bit of energy. Squeeze your bottom at the top. You can even slap it at the top just to make sure you're doing it. Because if it's flaccid, it hurts a lot more. Stop swiping someone else's. You're getting in trouble. 15 seconds. Try and get down to 90 degree angle if possible.
3, 2, 1.
Brilliant, change right. Exercise. Okay, so we're going to change exercise. We're going to do lateral box jumps. So this is why I put the box that way. What we're going to do is we're going to straddle the box on the step. We're going to jump up and down again. Bouncing on the front of your toes, but make sure you're actually on the full board.
3,
if you don't want to do that, just do side up, up, down, downs. And then we'll change halfway through for the up, up, down, downs. Let's go. So I'm keeping my knees slightly bent, hips back a little bit. So I've actually got a little bit of spring. So cushioning in the actual land. So anyone who's actually doing up, up, down, downs, sideways, change now. Five seconds. I'm almost coming off the board now. I keep moving backwards.
Changing.
Right. Oh, I'll move that sideways. There we go, move it out now. Right, so spotty dog. So this one, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go one arm up, one arm down. So we're gonna alternating sides.
3.
So we're just gonna, almost like walking on the spot.
Exercise 3.
Low impact to do it slow, nice and easy, like a soldier. Okay? Let's go. I'll get the music going. Keep it going. You can flip kick those feet out if you want. I like doing that. 10 seconds left. Three, two, one.
Change.
Next exercise, dumbbell uppercuts. Get the dumbbells slightly wide, the shoulder width apart, knees slightly bent because you will be bouncing from side to side slightly. Try and follow your knees along your toes. We're going to uppercut up,
3, 2,
twisting the wrist as you go,
exercise.
Trying to go from side to side, try not to smack yourself in the face, try and get a little bit of energy behind it, and definitely don't throw the weight across the room. Try and get that elbow back as well. We'll be doing this as well with the punch downs, but getting your elbow back will work the back of your shoulder, your rhomboids, and a bit of your biceps and triceps as well. 7 seconds. 5, 3, 2, 1. Good cardio, that one. Right. Bent over, reverse flies. So we're going to be using the dumbbells yet again. Shoulders apart, knees slightly bent, hips back. Bend over. Try and get as close to parallel as possible. You don't have to, but it helps. Dumbbells down by the side, get in front of your knees, and up by the side. Try and keep out to the side. Try not to go backwards. Keep it nice under control. If you climb, right, that's momentum. Try and stop it. You can touch them together, but it should be just a single or double tap. Not a... Don't try and clap with this one. Otherwise you might take off.
Three.
Two. One. Right, okay, next one, we've got tricep kick bikes. So again, we'll be bending over, elbows up, try and get those dumbbells back. I'm gonna change to some heavy ones. The further you get it back, the more you actually, you contract the tricep, which is the back of the arm. Try and do it under control as well, especially coming down. Don't let it just flop, because otherwise your arms will come down. So your elbows should only be moving if you can get your elbows far back like mine, like you, almost like you're skiing. So your elbow should not be going in front of your spine. 10 seconds.
Three, two, one.
Oh right, we missed one. Alternating shoulder press. Sorry, I did miss one. Alternating shoulder press. It's my fault. Right, so I will change that in the order of playing on the website, not on here. Because we're going to do it once. So we're going to alternate, so elbows in front, punch up, punch up, punch up, punch up. That's what we need to do. Try and keep your tummy tight. Try not to lean back or lean forward. Oh, we're going through them too fast. Now if you're a bit swish, you can actually, as you go down with one, you can go up with the other. But a lot of people tend to rock, so just be careful with that. I like to think of the control of one arm first, because you're concentrating just on that one muscle group. Brilliant, right. I'm going to go back to my lighter dumbbells and my tennis elbows kicking up. So we're going to do reverse lunge with a single raise. So I'm going to go back, and the green foot's forward. So the pink arm comes up. So we come up and we swap sides. So it's diagonal. So it's diagonal arm and leg.
Exercise age.
So up and down. You don't have to keep the dumbbells flat. If you want to keep them forward, you can do. I tend to have them always at a 45 degree angle. I find that best of both worlds. Depends on elbow health as well. Like, I find that harder than going hammer curl action on a tennis elbow. Golfer's elbow might be a little bit different.
Brilliant,
right, okay, last two exercises. So we got punch downs, nice wide stance, knees slightly bent, feet slightly facing outwards, bottom back. What we're gonna do is we're punching down in between the knees. That's why you need to keep your feet out.
Two,
so tummy tight, punch down, get those elbows up. Like you're trying to clean clothes with an old mandolin. God, you're gonna get those stains out. Someone's been sitting on grass and with a white shirt. Yeah, a little bob. As you can see, I tend to bob around a little bit. As long as it's not overly accentuated.
Three, two, one.
Brilliant, right.
Exercise.
Oblique jacks, you can put your dumbbells down. oblique jacks, low impact version, hands behind your ears, just bring one knee up to one elbow. If you want the high impact, you go up and jump. And we do the low impact because my toes hurt me at the moment. I don't want to actually wrist damage it anymore. Ten seconds. We're gonna try and get that crunch in. Don't just let your hips do the work. Five,
three, two, one.
Excellent, right, we're gonna bring the mats back. Well, sorry, the board back. Mine's on the mats because I find it doesn't slide around as much. I want a drink. Seems to be getting very close. Time recording, clouds are coming in. Temperature's going up remarkably fast. So I've recorded. Time recording, it's only 23 degrees, but it's still hot. Benefits and deficits of sweatbands is you can wipe your sweat off, but they make you sweat underneath. Right, so we'll start with up, up, down, down as per usual. I think what we'll do is we'll go up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down. So basically, one hand up as you go up, okay? I did swap feet actually on the first time I did this. So we're just gonna go arms out, one arm back, and then we'll swap over for the next time.
Three, two, one, exercise.
Let's go. Up, wrong foot. So opposite arms, whichever leg's leading. So I'm leading with the pink foot and the green arms going up. Nice and floaty light. Five seconds.
Three,
two, one. Brilliant, right, active rest. Let's swap sides for the floaty light step up. Floaty light step up, I like that. So I started with the pink and now I'm going to do the green. So I must remember this hand goes first.
Three, two, one.
And let's go.
Exercise two.
It's almost like you can see the hand that goes forward doesn't really bend. The hand that goes back, I'm tend to bending up almost to go into my side of my face. So you could have small dumbbells. So you're doing front raise with one hand, bicep curl, and then kick back with the other. If I'm going sideways, you can see I'm doing a bicep curl with a green hand and a kick back. Right, excellent. Active rest. That was a bit of a confusing one. Sorry about that. We're doing knee ups. Oh, that's getting a bit painful now. Two sessions is way too much at the moment.
Two,
I'm doing it. Let's get going.
Exercise three.
Knee ups. I need to remember to get my wife some peppermint tea. I drank it all last night. Sorry, strange things happen when you're actually just looking at the clock, seeing it count down.
Three,
I'm not sure if I'm doing that right, actually. Anyway, right, take your rest. You do flick kicks. So I'm going to go corner to corner. You can just do whatever you want. If you've got a small board, you can't go corner to corner. But if you do have a wide board, please do. Doesn't matter which foot you kick out. You can kick out the near leg to the camera, or as I'm doing, the far leg. Now, if you're in choreography, you have to do the same as everyone else. We're not. We're not in class either. Maybe in a class we would do.
Three, two, one.
I give rest. We do knee ups again. And I hope this time I get it right. Sorry, my brain just closed up there, I don't know why.
One.
Right, so knee ups.
Exercise five.
Oh, I did do them right. Right, doubles. Triples. One, two, three. One, two, three. Just another set. Now go back to doubles. Doubles. Singles.
Three. Oops. Two. One. Change exercise.
Right, active rest. We do. If you need to change the orientation, you can do it. You can just change whether you side up, up, down, downs.
Three, two, one.
Let's
exercise
go.
Six.
Try to use your feet as a springboard on this. You don't have to put your full foot down. It's more of a almost like a gazelle step. You're just stepping on the top of your toes. That aids in the balance. I used to run on my toes. People call it toe running. I used to call it gazelle running. So I look like a gazelle because it's such a large stride. And I actually did it faster.
Three, two, one.
Right. I'm just going to march on the spot across the board. And then we're going to do the same on the opposite foot. One, I'm starting on the green one now. Keep it going. 10 seconds left.
Three, two, one.
I'm taking mine back now. We're going to do split kicks. So, active rest. So, split kicks, step on, kick out, arms up. Swap sides. 5 seconds.
Three.
Oops.
Two. One. Exercise eight.
I think we've done well. Well, this is 5% low power. Brilliant. Almost there. Three, two, one. Brilliant, right, change exercise. So we're marching the spot. Up, up, down, down for the last two exercises. Nice and easy. Let's use it as a cooling down thing, so nice and slow, okay? Not too slow.
3, 2, 1. Exercise 9.
Nice and easy. Don't have to bring those knees up too high. Let's try and beat the clock of the battery running out. Right, 7 seconds. I'm trying to think what to do after that, and suddenly realise that this is the end of the set.
Change exercise.
Right, active rest. So I'm going to swap on my other leg now for the last up, up, down, down.
Three, two, one.
Exercise. And up, down, down. So on this one, what I'm going to do is, I'm actually just going to talk to you actually, briefly. I'm thinking of actually compiling a client favourites. So whatever your favourite exercises are in these classes, if you can send me a message, I'd like to compile a class on your favourites. If I don't get enough, I'll have to work around it. But it would be really, really nice. I know everyone's got favourites. Everyone's probably got one or two. Put them all in. I'll see if I can get them all in. If we get up too many, I'll do two or three classes like that. Right, cool down. So now let's just flick those feet off ever so slightly to keep that blood flowing as well. Nice cool down. So this is another good way of cooling down. Just keeping your blood working. Right, so what we're going to do is stand shoulder width apart, feet facing forward, hands on our thighs, stick your hips back, roll down. Feel those hamstrings, the back of your leg pulling. Bring it down to your toes. Try and look at the floor in front. Try not to look at the floor behind, because otherwise that encourages a rounding of the spine, particularly in the shoulders. You might notice that I've got a slight bend in my back there, but that's natural. Also depends on genetics as well. So you can actually change it by just putting your shoulder blades back, if you notice there. Shoulder blades back and down. But I can't reach my toes. Excellent. Let's try and go a little bit further down. Really feel that stretch. It should be uncomfortable, not painful. If it's painful, there is a difference between uncomfortable and painful. A lot of people in modern society don't seem to be able to differentiate between the two. And it's what we need to get back to. We need to understand what discomfort is and understand it, because when you're hungry, you should be uncomfortable. If no one in this country has ever been, I don't think, starving unless you're homeless or unless you've been abused. So we don't know that, so we call that pain. It's not. That's why it's uncomfortable, but it's that people think it's painful. That same with stretching or doing exercise. Right, we're going to come back up now because we're stressed out for quite a long time, which is good. And we're going to do a thigh stretch now. This time we're going to get the raised knee behind the knee on the floor. And we're going to look up and pull into our glutes, not to the side, but into the glutes. We're going to hold it for quite a while. So pretend you are the Rolls Royce. Or pan on the on change legs. Fisherman friends roundabout at Fleetwood. I think he's got a bow. Not too sure. Don't have to. 3, 2, 1. and down. Right, so what we're going to do now is open up our chest, hands forward, put your hands over, push back, try and get the shoulder blades down. Two, one, and up. Stretch up. And release. And thank you very much all for coming. I hope you had enjoyed this session of Step Up, pre-recorded. I hope to see you all on Friday for the live one, which you've already have done. And after that, I'll be recording the one for Friday. Coming. It can get confusing, I'm sorry. But anyway, I hope you all had a good week. Enjoy the day. God bless and take care. And I'll see you all later. Take care for now.